Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Welcome back to the Nirvaana Shatkam series. In the first three videos, we have seen Jagadguru Shri Adi Shankaracharya explain what is our true self, the Atman, by explaining what it is not. He says the mind, the sense organs, elements, life force, body and its functions are not the true nature of the Atman. The self is the soul or the Atman, a reflection of the Brahman. It is covered in ignorance and falsely believes itself to be the body-mind complex. Only when the soul is turned towards Brahman does it break through the illusion of Maya and recognize its true nature. In the next few verses, Adi Shankara describes the true nature of the self from the point of an Atmajnani, one who has realized the self himself. When he talks about things saying, Name, Name, not mine, he actually means that these things do not belong to the soul.
Name dvesha-raaga, Name lobha moha, mado naiva me naiva matsarya bhava, na dharmo na chartho, na kamo na moksha, chidana.
Name dvesha ragav, name lobha mohav. Neither do I have dvesha, hatred, nor raga, attachment. Neither lobha, greed, nor moha, infatuation. The feelings of like and dislike are perceptions of the mind and the sense organs. If I liked some experience, I remember the sensation of pleasure and look forward to it in the future. It is dictated by impressions and memories. All these are the domain of the manas and chitta. Therefore, these emotions are not those of the Atman. Mado naiva me naiva matsarya bhava. I do not have mada, pride, nor matsarya, envy or jealousy. I feel pride or jealousy only when I compare myself with another. These emotions arise out of the ego, which thinks of me as being different from others. Dvesha, raga, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya are the Shad Ripus, six internal enemies. Also called Arishad vargas, the six passions of mind, these feelings have their source in the mind, sense organs, memories and perceptions, but they are born only because of one reason, the ego. We feel these emotions and act in wrong ways because we allow ourselves to believe that we are this person different from another. As seen in the earlier verses, we understand that Atman, our true self, is not affected by any of our actions. What if I understood that I reside in each and everything around me? I would be happy when my friend scores first, because when she wins, I understand that one of me is succeeding. I would be happy when my neighbor wins a lottery. I understand then one of me is prosperous. I would be happy under all circumstances. Even when one of me dies, because I understand that another of me is born elsewhere. With such an outlook, as an Atmajnani, one who identifies himself as the Atman, Shankaracharya feels samadrishti, which means that everyone is the same in his eyes. He understands that the same Brahman shines in all Atmas. Identifying himself with the Atman, he therefore does not feel hatred, passion, greed, infatuation, pride or jealousy. Na dharmo na chartho na kamo na mokshah. I am not bound by the four Purusharta, he says. Dharma, righteous conduct. Artha, possessions or wealth, kama, desires, moksha, liberation. The Purusharthas are the four pursuits of each soul during this journey called life. The purpose of the soul is to experience the world and then attain Brahman. Kama means desire and artha means possessions. Through desires, the soul is propelled to act and interact and enjoy the world. This is made possible by acquiring possessions or artha. These are the requirements for the first part of this journey. Brahman is the source of all dharma, the natural order, or the laws within all of creation. The human intellect, unlike in other beings, is capable of free will. Thus, it can choose to operate within the dictates of dharma, or it may choose to defy it. Being a reflection of Brahman, the Atman or soul holds the knowledge of dharma. We can call the soul our inner consciousness, the place from where we know when something feels right or wrong. By following this inner moral compass, we can understand dharma instinctively. Thus, it is possible to pursue kama and acquire artha in a dharmic fashion. Having thus pursued kama and artha, there comes a time when we start the journey towards self-inquiry. Who am I? What is my true purpose? Then we start looking inwards. We try to uncover the Atman which is covered in ignorance. This inquiry will eventually lead us towards moksha, self-realization. Once the ignorance is gone, we see that the Atma is beyond moksha, as it is never bound. Only what is bound needs to be liberated. An Atmajnani like Shankara knows this. He has no need for the Purusharthas. Therefore he asks, of what use are all these to me, the Atma? Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. I am the ever pure blissful consciousness. I am Shiva. I am Shiva. Summing up verse 4, Jagadguru Sri Aji Shankaracharya says, neither do I have hatred nor attachment, neither greed nor infatuation, nor pride nor envy nor jealousy. I am not bound by righteous conduct, possessions, desires or liberation. I am the ever pure blissful consciousness. I am Shiva. I am Shiva. In this Shatkam, Shankaracharya explains the nature of Atman using negation. Na aham. I am not this, I am not that. The best way to arrive at the true nature of Atman is by negating everything else which it is not. This is the style used in the Upanishads to explain the nature of Brahman. Neti neti, not this, not that, is used as a tool to peel away the temporary and unreal in order to indicate the real nature of Brahman. In the next two verses, Shankaracharya as an Atmajnani continues to use the style of negation to unfold the truth of the Atman. I hope you are enjoying this insightful composition. In the next video, we will look at the fourth verse. Hari Om.